Outside, it's a freezing Arctic wasteland, but inside, it's loud, hot, and rowdy. Welcome to the Thunderdome. We're broadcasting live from Cinerapolis, Forsk, Minnesota. The fans are wearing parkas and shorts, ready for the carnage to begin. Today's matchup promises severed limbs and ruined careers, and lots of beers. The insane Colts go up against the Purple Mutant Eaters. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Yo, man, nobody can touch an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
Welcome to MFL Sunday School, where the good playbook teaches it's an eye for no reason, a tooth for an eight ball, and a limb for just looking at me the wrong way. MFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow, my partners Bricks and Bricks Jr. Hey, man, these guys flat out want to kill each other today.
Yeah, these are the kind of games families come out to see. It's good for the sport.
You know what I like about this home team is 90% of them were born criminally insane. You can't teach that. And it's first and 10. Second down and more than the QB would like. He could go all the way. Third down and 3. Dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him. Ah, going in circles.
And it's first and 10. It was a risky throw in the defense. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after 3, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
I personally think that the ginormous guy is compensating for... Oh, he just got crushed! Second down and 6.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Oh, and they just deflated the quarterback's balls right there.
Hey, you see that move, baby? No, you didn't. You know why? I'm too fast for you. I'm the greatest, I tell you.
Third down and, well, good luck.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And he breaks away. He broke free and has open field in front of him. He's at the 10, and then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though?
Yeah, man.
Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
First and 4.
Hot one, hot two,
rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not gonna dance now.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. Yeah. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make him pay. And he just wrestles away from that tackle. And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
And it's first and 10. And he's off to the races. Second down and 10. Just a great run for a touchdown. Since when is that a penalty?
Since now, I guess, Ben.
Second down and long, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. Second down in a mile. And the defense gets... Anyone in the mood for Mutant Tartar? Oh, with the brain scrambler.
I know why they said never hit a man when he's down. He's just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
Good game for Tartar. My only weak amateur.
And it's first and 10. Huge pass play for 1 yard. Second down and 9. Does the QB know which?
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
What it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice grin. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And he reels that one in for a first down to keep the drive up.
Bingo! Bingo! I just hit that mutant bingo! And all I was missing was his number for the last 3 plays. Talk about luck!
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Second down and a lot.
Hot one, hot two.
The QB looks angry at his offensive line, and I can't blame him. Third down, and the punter is warming up. And kickers practice for this kind of kick every day. Pretty standard.
Nothing standard when you got bloodthirsty mutants on the defensive line.
The kick is good.
As expected. Those are pretty...
Hey, Bricks, check the rule book. Is that a penalty?
Why would I have the rule book?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Man, this coach must have... Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. He's got the ball now in his... Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And it's first and 10. Caught for the first down. First and 10. A good run for 5 yards.
Hey, didn't move the change of score, did it? How good can it be?
Second down and 5. That's the end of the first quarter, and it's still anyone's game. Second down and 5. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and 10. And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his Sleeties this morning. Great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Second down in a very lot.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh no, it's the sticky ball dirty trick. The defense pretty much turned the ball into a yo-yo of doom.
Did you ever think you'd say that, Grim? A yo-yo of doom?
No, my friend, I didn't. I love this job. Third down in forever.
Hot one, hot two.
With multiple interceptions, the QB should just... Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and 10. Yeah, it looks like the coach is ripping that play from the playbook. What a dud. Second down and 10.
It's a zap attack. It's like when you...
Oh, and he fumbles the ball on that hit. When you hurl and get hit, chances for a fumble increase. And like Bricks' bowels, he is loose and heading for the end zone. He could go all the way. He's at the 40. He's at the 30. The 20. The 10. Oh, what a run there. Touchdown. Stop him.
Yeah.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and ten. Oh, this guy just loves punishing. Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I gotta see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row, because that was splattering everywhere. And it's first and ten. Right rage ignites that deep down violent. And that's another turnover for the defense. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. Boom, dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
Now, still working on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep. Second down and six. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me.
Get the hell out of here, man.
And it's first and ten.
Hot. Hot one.
You know what they say? Sometimes the best offense. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. First and ten.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Two minutes remain in the half.
Wait! I gotta take a dump!
It's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hey!
Moving the quarterback said they'd blow up the defense today. He was right. Kapow! Second down and ten.
Hot one.
Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds.
The quarterback calls a timeout to stop the clock. They have two left. First and four.
Hot one. Hot two.
Well, 1 yard is better than nothing, but not by much. Second and three.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Hey, man, nobody can touch me when I ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about, Pop?
They quickly call a timeout, hoping to save some time for their offense. Third down and five.
Hot one, hot two.
And he runs it for 4 yards. And the D takes their second timeout, hoping for a miracle.
I witnessed a miracle once. A player was brought back from the dead.
That's not a miracle, partner. That's just how the MFL works. Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and ten.
What are you trying to replace your third family?
And that pass play is good for 8 yards. And that's it. That's the last timeout. It's score or die from here out. And the offense goes into the hurry-up formation to try to conserve time. Man, what a hit that was. And it looks like we've got a penalty here. The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only two left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Glenn, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. Other than the funeral expenses, that is.
When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. Oh, the defender almost picked off the ball on that one. And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? That's when it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made it.
And the offense has only two running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last two runners for this outman.
Thank God he's still got his leg. He's going to need all of it for this kick. He's got the distance, and the kick is good. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And he just slipped away like a greased pig. And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run. Boom to the moon. Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much what you wanted, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They had the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
At the end of quarter two, it's a blowout. We now go to our halftime show sponsored by Monsanto Industries, makers of great killer products like Groundup. Use it on pesky weeds or neighbors, and they'll be gone by morning. We're back for the second half in a blowout. The teams line up for the kickoff.
What a game is this close as the score indicates.
The onside kick is a desperation play, but it's their only chance at this point to steal a possession.
Stealing ain't right, Grim. It just ain't right.
Oh, and that kick to his highlight reel. That was perfect. And since he's a kicker, that brings him up to a one-hole highlight. And it's first and ten. Game picking up some steam, a gain of seven there. Second and three. And he punched his way in.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
And it's first and ten. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down in a mile. Roid rage. Because if you can't answer your question, and with another pick, the QB says, I don't always throw interceptions, but when I do, it's when the game is on the line. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 98.8, the greatest hits of all time.
Did you just say greatest hits? Where?
Running back. When he bites the dust, they can only pass.
Yeah, well, at least they don't have to forfeit, Ben.
That's right, but now the defense can focus on killing the receivers. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot
three. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a... And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
And he picks up 2 yards on the catch. And that'll be second and eight to go.
Hot one, hot two.
Running back. No rest for the weary. The last runner has to suck it up and hopefully not die. They're down in eight.
Hot one, hot two.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
Oh, no good. Now that punter's gonna, and he just lets that one go. He says, no thank you, and the defense downs it. And it's first and 10. Destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. And he scores! The offense lost their final running back. Lucky for them, they're on defense now.
They're lucky to survive so much bad luck.
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and 10.
Paper, I scared one shiver. I don't hear what I was selling.
Second down and long. Another pick. Man, oh man, the defense is going to have more receptions than the offense. And he's off to the races. Boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
One quarterback left. If he dies, it's game over.
Yeah, this new QB, he don't even look too confident. He's pleading with the coach on the sidelines about something.
Yeah, he's telling his coach to punt. What a pussy.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It's good. Looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and 10. And they call a low-key dirty trick. This play is usually good for a quick score because no one can catch this guy. Look at him. He's like feeding a Dallas.
Hey, man, I was hanging on the kettle now. You know what?
Second down and a lot. And that one's incomplete. The receiver couldn't get there.
And yeah, neither could his mother.
Third down and long. This guy's a brick shithouse. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. And it's first and 10. Oh, man, Bricks, you got to love a player who goes down fighting.
Ghost.
purple mutant eaters are annihilated at home today.
Looks like someone put the mutant eaters on a diet. Get it? Diet? Because they're dead and forfeiting. Forget it.
It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't going to make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were going to kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare while tripping my brains out.
Actually, that sounds kind of fun.
Once again, the folks at Evil SN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Hard Corporation. They get it right every up.